Gut, mein bad. Greetings, my friends, countrymen, warriors, all that have gathered here, this final part of the first saga of my story. As I gained final vengeance against Sven the Bullneck, we had cornered the scoundrel at Reddingham. And so we approached with an army ready for vengeance. Enemy lookouts watch you closely from the walls of Reddingham. The site has good defenses and a moat. There are still remnants of previous battles. When the Saxons tried to expel the Danish, it was a good position to defend. You notice that a group of men approaching you. It is led by a tall man. This must be Eadric, the man mentioned by Ilfret. Let's talk with him then. Egbert Eric, my lord has advised me that you're to come. Sven the Bullneck has taken Reedrum and has many men with him, mainly Danish, who have sworn allegiance. They are tough, battle-hardened people, same as Sven, who is a legend in his own right. I would not like to be in the shoes of you or your men. Do you know of a mother? Do you know of a woman who might be with him? You mean your mother? Is Sadie right? Yes, she's with them. We saw her when she entered Reedrum with Sven the Bullneck. I do not know how she was before, but now she's very gaunt and thin. I do not think she has long to live. Well, from what I've heard, you're also someone dangerous. I will leave the half and 100 men I promised my lord I would. They are brave warriors who have been promised a lot of gold to help you. So fight well. Farewell, Egbert Derek, and good luck. The site had good defenses in the moat. A lot of previous battle, yes. We approached Reedrum then. Another hour. Alone. To have a little talk with Sven and see if I can get my mother out of here before the brutal vengeance started. I saw him from the distance as I approached. My blood both boiling and freezing at the same time.
Ha! I knew you would come, Egbert Derek. You and me have unfinished business that must be concluded. The blood of my brother, Ulfir Whitehair, still stained your hands. Thanks to you, I had to turn against my lord Sigurd and Harald, and a lot of other things.
You and you alone are the cause of your ruin, Sven! You should never have attacked me and the Wooden Rick. Now, free my mother, and let's settle this between you and me!
I think not! She is my wife, my senior. If you want her, come get her. But have a care. You might find my sword instead.
Yes. Your mother looks tired and withered, and she says,
my little one, I see your face and I remember. I regret everything you had to do for my sake. Go. Go and live. I will die soon. Sven is a murderer and a madman. Do not give him the satisfaction of killing you.
Shut up, woman! You see, your little one has decided to die. Egbert Derek, here I wait. Come and get me if you dare. My brother Ulf will be glad that I send you to the halls of hell.
Well, I guess there's no talking here. Total assault! Move for what? Ambush! Sven's men behind me. Do not give him the satisfaction of making their cowardly tactics work. Cut them all down, my men! Show them that justice is with our side this day, and that we are stronger than these cowards! Lie down and die! Your steel will not help you now! might. Slaughter to the last. Now, charge forward! Ah! Just watch them all die! Die! Stiff! 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 Tools and you all about! I will have your heads! All the heads! And I'll toss them at Sven until he is dead by your heads! Now you still want to fight, do you? Don't run, you coward! Yeah! Let me just get my breath back, and then I'll be ready for more vengeance. Right, field cleared, let us move in. The meager defenses will not stop my vengeance! Stop resisting! Oh, you're hiding up there, are you? Well, guess my crossbow will need some training. Ah, there you are. Right, you celebrate and finish off the rest of them. I will go and get Sven. He must be hiding in the center there. Sven! I'm coming for you. Are you nearly done? Let me through! Fine. There. Good job, man. Now, bash in this door! The slaughter continues in Rindrum. Your men were still fighting in the remnants of Sven's troop, but that was not the battle you sought. No, that was not the battle I sought. Sven the Bullneck had barricaded himself in the meat hall of Rindrum, taking your mother, my mother, and a few men with him. It's time to end this party. Is this what you wanted? Do you still think you can win? I'm still alive, and I warned you she will be dead.
My little one, I love you. Remember that your mother has always loved you, and will watch from wherever I go.
No. No. No! 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 Die! I... am... angry! Now, you... warriors, eh? You will not stop me. None will stop me! Die, Sven. Go to your brother in the afterlife. Sven the Bullneck finally lay dead. I had accomplished my revenge, but I was left with a bitter taste in my mouth, because my mother's dead body lay near Sven's. The woman who had raised me, for her, I had left everything behind to seek a healer in Frieza, in the north of Frieza, such a dangerous land. Her last words of love resonated in my mind like a distant echo. Sven, the Bullneck, and my mother have been the energy that has have driven me so far. But both were dead now. I felt a void, as if part of me went with them. After everything that happened, all I had left was the memories. I came to a funeral, sheathing my sword. Under a dark sky. I had found a Gurdy to help her on the way to Valhalla. And so, I went to the ship I thought would serve her best. While my Sue was never a woman of the sword, but a crossbow might take her enemies from afar so that she would not be taken down again by men such as Sven. So, and in her arms, I lay down my crossbow. May it serve her well in taking down running enemies and the monsters that were undoubtedly waiting in the night in the hills or in Valhalla. Whatever he was, battle would be her for her.
My name is Beda, and this book started as a chronicle of a dark time. But the time is not so dreadful as it was overshadowed by a hero. I was there when the armies of Saxons and Danes fought at Iskenden. I was there when Egbert Tyrk changed the course of history. But even this, and what happened next, pales in importance to when the world lost its hero. I remember it like it just happened, when we entered the hall and watched as Sven de Boonek finished off Egbert Tyrk's mother. I remember his face. It became cold as ice, neither anger nor fear nor crying, only coldness. I assure you that Sven de Boonek turned pale because he knew that his death was inevitable. We fought in the hall and Sven died, but that did not change the hardness on the of the face of Egbert Tyrk, neither then nor later at the funeral of his mother. Revered like a queen and buried with a rich grave of goods in a warship. After that day, we lost our hero. He said his farewell to us, who we had followed him from battle to battle. It is said that he was leaving without revealing his destination. He left us, I fear, never to return. I hope I am wrong, because this world, this dark world, still stands in need of his exploits. After the departure of our leader, we, his followers, dispersed to the four winds. I hid in a monastery in the remote parts of West Saxony. Far from it all, here I will wait for the end of my days. I pay people to bring me news from the outside, especially if they find Egbert Tyrk, but nobody has seen him. However, I have little news from the others who were with him until the end. Little news has reached me of young Kaio. I do know for sure that he never returned to Hadrian's Wall, not even to visit his family. Last I heard is that he embarked on a Danish expedition, headed to Constantinople. Brunhild married a Dane, despite having always hated them, and settled near Jorvik. A merchant told me that currently she's happy. She's a happy mother with three children. Mogrund returned to Cornobia and sought to unite the clans to try and recover the territory of the old kingdom of Dunmonia. But it was unsuccessful. Many were simply abandoning their homeland for the other side of the channel, which amazingly enough failed to reduce the many rivalries.
In the end, he gave up and retired to the monastery of Petrokstal, where I know he took the vows. The Weiwei, despite all the past, never resigned herself to the departure of Egbert Dirk. I heard she left in pursuit of him. The Greek, Augustinos, stayed in the north, near Ludenwick, where he got a job rebuilding the old Roman infrastructure. Sometimes I get letters from him. I do not know why we were never friends, but he likes to keep up the relations he made in his past, and I must be the only remnant of another time he left. And that is all of what I know of the people who served under Egbert Dirk. I hope my writings serve to keep Egbert Dirk in history, the man who started from nothing on a ship called the Woden Rick, and rose to be a warlord who was able to put in check the powers of his time. He it was who killed the dreaded Sven the Bullneck, and could be measured face to face with the most powerful men like the sons of Ragnar and the kings of West Saxe. May the world remember Egbert Dirk when the rest of us have all perished.
And so came the end of that first saga. Indeed, I had to leave for a while, settle my affairs, think on my destiny, think on things I still wanted, needed to do in these North Sea Isles. And eventually, return I did. The grand plan. A plan to finally bring order to my homeland. But that will be a tale for the next chapter. It will be, it was a more fortuitous and less convoluted chapter as, I'd gathered power and, you'll see. For now, I hope you have enjoyed this story of revenge, a tragedy, sadness, blood and battle. Wees gezond, my dear listeners. Wees gezond.